So far, Uganda is implementing a three-year economic program supported by the IMF running up to June 2024. The aim of this financial support is to enable Uganda's economic recovery, ensuring public debt remains stable, supporting Uganda's external position, increasing domestic revenue mobilization, and increased efficiency in public expenditure. Upon the successful expenditure of the $1 billion in the past 3 years, Uganda will now receive an additional $120 million to fund budget activities.
Announcing under the ECF-backed economic program has been crucial in maintenance of fiscal sustainability. So far, a total of $750 million, that's about 541.5 million SDR, has been disbursed following the previous four reviews of the program.
The continued commitment to fiscal consolidation is particularly important to reduce risks and safeguard sustainability. Enhancing revenue by redoubling efforts to implement the domestic revenue mobilization strategy will provide space to maintain critical expenditures and rely less on costly borrowing. In the context of consolidation, improving the composition of spending is key to maintaining social services and support to the most vulnerable and providing space for growth enhancing capital expenditures.
Some of the achievements registered through the program include maintenance of macroeconomic stability, where appropriate and well-coordinated monetary and fiscal policies have resulted in a decline to headline inflation from a peak of 10.7% in October 2022 to 3.4% as of February 2024. Similarly, the foreign exchange rates have been stable to peers in the region, while the foreign exchange reserves have also maintained a healthy level.
Remember last year we began to see some pressures in the currency because the seasonal inflows were not as strong as they used to be. And then we also saw heightened demand from manufacturing firms and other key players in the sector, like the telecoms, like the energy companies, because we also think the international prices of oil begin to pick up.
Story by Rachel Nachwala for the news.